everyone, welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all doing extremely well. So today I'm going to be filming, as you can tell by the title, a video on how I take and edit my Instagram photos. This is hands down the most asked question I get all the time, ever. I get asked this question daily, so many times. So I am finally sitting down and filming a video on it for you guys. So yeah, I'm not gonna ramble too much because there would be no point in that, but yeah, I'm just going to jump straight into the video and I hope you enjoy. Okay, so when it comes to the history of my Instagram, I didn't always have a fancy camera to take my photos with. When I first started my Instagram, I would only use my iPhone, and that did a pretty awesome job. I started out with the iPhone 5 and I literally only used the front camera on it. Hold on. I now have the iPhone 6, but when I first started out, it was the iPhone 5, and I would literally just use the front camera and take selfies or whatever. Then I upgraded to my iPhone 6, but I don't really use my phone for photos anymore, except when I do close eye shots, I struggle with zooming on my camera, so I don't even bother. But when I want to get like a close-up shot of my eye, I literally just open it up. For some reason, I always have to use like the Instagram thing. And I just grab a like compact with a mirror, point the camera to how I want to, and I use the mirror to kind of see what I'm doing. And then when I'm happy with what I see, I just snap a photo. And I know this is how a lot of people would take like front-on selfies with their phone. They would kind of use the same method, mirror look, but that never worked for me. I don't know if I'm just a weirdo, but does anyone else struggle with doing that? Like, it doesn't matter how big the mirror is in front of me, I can never just get a good shot with my phone. And I don't know why, but YOLO. Just didn't work out for me. But yeah, so what I do use now to take my photos on Instagram is this bad boy. This is my child. This is the Sony Alpha A6000 camera. And it has a pull-out screen, which is honestly really of no use because I can't really flip it out, but you know. But yes, this is pretty much all I use for my Instagram photos, but as I mentioned before, little eyeball shots, I use my phone. But I know I'm going to get a lot of questions in the comments about how much this camera costs, and I'll just let you guys know, it probably varies from country to country. I'm sure it will be cheaper in the US than it is in Australia, because like the dollar is different and whatnot. But I bought mine around Christmas time, and I got it with the 16-50mm lens with a zoom lens, and it cost me about $900. I know it's probably not as much in America, and the price has probably dropped a little bit since it was last year, and I don't know if they've released a new model or not. But yeah, I bought it for $900. I will leave it a link down below if I can find it on any websites. But yeah, moving on to the actual photo taking part of this video, I'm always getting asked about what settings I have this camera on and what lights I stand in front of when I'm taking my photos. I'll let you guys know, I usually don't have any lights up. I usually only have my lights on when I am filming my YouTube videos, but for the most part when I'm taking my selfies, I feel so weird saying that, I hate saying selfies, but when I do take my Instagram photos, I will either stand in front of this window, or I'll just stand up against the wall or anything. Any random place in my room, doesn't really matter. The only lighting I do use though is on the camera itself. It is this bad boy right here. This flash is literally all the lighting I need. It's just, it's life, okay? But yeah, I don't really play around with the settings too much. I have changed a couple of things recently because I only just recently learned how to use it properly. But I'll zoom you guys in on this part and kind of explain a little bit more in depth. Yeah, as I mentioned, I get a lot of questions on what settings I have this camera on. I don't really play with the settings too much. There's only a few things that I kind of play with on this camera because it is a little bit complicated, but I'm just going to show you guys what I do. So a lot of you ask me how I kind of get the smooth skin in my photos. I don't airbrush my skin too much, but this camera does have a skin smoothing option. So I'm just going to show you how to get to that. When you press the menu, it brings you to the kind of camera page. It has all these options on and settings and all that kind of stuff. But I'm just going to use this button to kind of navigate through to the 6th page, where it will come up with an option for soft skin effect. You click on that, and I keep mine on low. I don't really like to put it too much higher because I personally don't like my skin to look way over the top airbrushed in my photos, but that's completely up to you. You can put it up to medium or you can put it up to high. Totally optional, it's your preference, but I keep mine on low. And yeah, so when I take my photos, my flash is always up, and that's literally all I do. Now, what I love about this camera is that it also has Wi-Fi, so you can, instead of having to plug in your camera to like your iPad or your camera, you can just send the photos to your phone from here. So how I do that is I go to the Wi-Fi symbol, and here it has an option, send to smartphone. I click on that, and you have an option where you can select the photos on this device or you can select on smartphone. I always go with select smartphone because I like to pick them on my phone because it's a lot easier. So you click on that, and because my memory card has no images right now, it's not going to let me, but usually you would just go to the Wi-Fi thingy on your phone and yeah, click that, and it automatically connects. And what I didn't know actually is that you have to have an app to be able to do that. You can't just Wi-Fi connect your phone and the camera and automatically have the photos be sent to you. You have to have the Play Memories mobile app, I think that's what it's called. I'll leave it down below. And yeah, so that is pretty much all the settings that I play with. I don't play with anything else. I don't know how to do the aperture or ISO. That's all stuff that I still have to figure out, but yeah. Okay, so as for apps that I use for editing, the main ones I use are Afterlight, and I use that for like filters and cropping and stuff like that. I use Square Ready if I have a photo that's too big and I need to cut it down to a square for Instagram, I'll use Square Ready. Fonto is what I use to make all my text posts, like, you know, when I post something and it's just all text, I use Fonto. I use Diptyque and Maldive for collages. Lapsit is one that I downloaded for videos, but I never really use that. I just use the iMovie that is on my phone. Little Moments is a really cute text app for photos where you can add filters on photos and really cute text and images, and I use this app a lot for my YouTube thumbnails. And I've also got Facetune. Facetune I use if I have like a photo and I have like, I don't know, sweat on my top lip or something really ugly in my skin, like a little pimple, I'll use Facetune and I'll smooth that out. And yeah, Play Memories is the app that I use to transfer photos from my camera to my phone. But yeah, I don't use all of these apps too often. My most used app is probably Diptyque or Maldive, one or the other. They're both collage apps, or Square Ready. Whoops. Or Square Ready. But yeah, actually that's a lie. My most used app is definitely the Play Memories. That one is definitely the most used on my whole phone. So yeah, I'm just going to demonstrate to you guys how I kind of take the photo and edit and whatnot. And yeah, so now I'm just going to show you guys how I take the photos and upload and all that kind of stuff. So I flip the flash up. That one was actually pretty quick. Usually I take like 50 selfies to get the perfect one, but I did that in 4. So that has to be a new record, right? Yeah, so now I'm just going to send that to my phone. It comes up on the screen with like the password for the Wi-Fi for them to connect. And I'm just going to jump onto my phone, click on the Wi-Fi, and on the Wi-Fi it should come up with like the, I don't know if you can see that, I don't know if it's focusing, but it has the Wi-Fi for the camera. And you just click it and it connects. Just jumping onto my phone, jumping onto the Play Memories app, waiting for that to load, and there we go. So I'll just pick the photo that I want. And I press copy, and it copies the photo. So here is the photo that I took. So I am now just going to jump onto Instagram as Viva Glam K. If you don't follow her, you totally should. but jumping onto that, and there was nothing that I really want to edit with the photo, so I'm just going to zoom in, place it where I want, press next. And one thing that I do that I forgot to mention is in the Instagram app they have options, and I like to click the sharpen, and I like to sharpen my image a little bit. I don't know if you can see the difference in that, or sometimes I even like to kick up the warmth here on Instagram. It has an option, and I like to turn up the warmth just a little bit. See, I don't know if you can see that difference. It doesn't make too much of a difference, but it does make a bit of a difference. That is that. You go next. Yep, so just type in what you want to type in, share to Twitter and Tumblr, and then share. And that is pretty much it.
But yeah, that's literally all I do with my Instagram photos. Like, I very rarely open them up in an app and edit them. I usually do that more if I have like a smudge on my face and I want to fix that up. Then I will jump into Facetune and like do a little patch or whatever. But that's literally it. My camera does all the work for me. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was kind of worth the wait, and I hope I answered all your questions. I hope that everything you wanted to know was in this video. If you have any further questions, leave them down below and I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. But yeah, if you did enjoy this video, please give me a thumbs up. That would mean the world and really help me a lot. And yeah, leave any video requests down below. I always read those and add them to my list of things to film for you guys, which is awesome because I love like knowing what you guys want to see, because sometimes I get really confused as to what I should film because I want to do something that you guys like. If you have anything that you want to see, leave it down below. More than happy to film it for you guys. But yeah, thank you guys once again for watching. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.